Hello once again, guys. Buzz Killington here, and today's video is on the subject of diamonds, specifically diamond characters. What I thought I'd do briefly in this one is just to do a little talk about the characters that I'm bringing up to diamond that are already there or will be elevating, why I've done it, and of course let me know in the comments what particular characters you're choosing to focus on, what you think of the choices I'm making, and if there's any you think I should be focusing more attention on than I am. So yeah, starting with the obvious one right here, Morgan Ra, my first and so far only character at Diamond 2. I mean, the reasons for elevating this guy kind of speak for themselves. His armor is pathetic though, isn't it? Diamond 2 and he's not even got 1,000 armor. It's awful. But apart from that, he is an absolute terror on the battlefield. He's good and practically required for pretty much every guild raid boss. There's arguments maybe for not including him against the Rogaldorn tank, but even then you could argue that he is worth taking. But yeah, what does that say about him? Like, he's strong, he does really well in arena. You can just leave him there and he'll just basically shoot cat down any character that approaches him really convincingly. He does well in legendary events. He's really good, as I say, against a multitude of guild raid bosses. So he's a no-brainer about one to take, really. So yeah, I decided to push him to Diamond 2. He was at Diamond 1 already. Decided to elevate him, and it was a good decision, I think. Ooh, that was the wrong button. My next character is Cut Skodan, the heavy-breathing ogrin over here. He's at Diamond 1 at the moment. You may be wondering, why Cut Skodan? Firstly, why not Cut Skodan? He looks like he's wearing tank tracks as a groin guard, and he quite possibly is doing that. But yeah, the armor, the fact that he is a big old target, and I initially elevated him to Diamond for one reason and one reason alone, the Screamer Killer. The Screamer Killer will throw characters away like nobody's business, but this guy just stands there and thinks it's like a light breeze. He hits damn hard too. He's part of my permanent arena team. 1658 damage per hit. 4 hits. It doesn't even really matter if it's physical damage. He does a hell of a lot. Couple him with Eldrion and he can pretty much one-hit kill most things in arena. He's got utility in legendary events as well and events in general. And yeah, there's a few guild raid bosses he's pretty good at as well. Just outside of just a Screamer Killer, he can hit things pretty damn hard. And that's really all you want, isn't it? My next choice is one that I'm currently working on, Thaddeus Noble. I've got him to Silver 3. I plan to push him all the way to Diamond 1. He was woefully underleveled at Silver 1. But I'm elevating him now. And the reasons are pretty obvious, as anyone who's faced Thaddeus Noble will know. Sorry, I've got to do that every time. It's like his ranged blast attack, 862 damage per hit. Admittedly, 15% pierce ratio, but it is pretty good damage even at Silver 3. And of course, he doesn't need line of sight, really. Indirect fire is a real thing. And of course, his attacks suppress. And suppression is a really useful ability to have, of course. I've boosted his little spotter ability, so he will actually pair pretty well sitting next to Morgan Ra to give him even more damage than he already had. But he pairs really nicely with other heavy weapon characters such as Vindictor as well. But yeah, this guy is one I've been my eye on for a while. Want to get him to Diamond 1. He has utility against a particular guild raid boss. I'm thinking Mortarion here, and I'm going to talk about why in just a little bit. But yeah, he's just pretty damn powerful, and I've had my eye on him for a while, and that's why he's going up to Diamond next. After that, I'm toying with which order I'm going to do things. Bellator is a strong contender, and again, reasons speak for themselves. He produces very strong troops. At level 38, they actually have more bolter damage per thing than him. Although not quite as much health, but he can summon up to 6 of them, and they are very tanky with pretty damn decent armor, of course. And yeah, at Diamond, he's got his Gravis armor, which of course means incoming damage has to go through 2 times, unless it's a crit, which gives him that survivability. And unlike, say, Marnius Kalgar, who is pretty tanky, he's flyer, he's got the mobility, he can zip across the battlefield, get the damage done. Again, he's also good against quite a few guild raid bosses. He can tie them up deploy his summons at the right moment, he can get a lot of damage done, especially with, of course, with the passive. Any Inceptor adjacent to him will attack eligible targets, get him right in the middle of them, and they're going to be laying down a world of hurt. So yeah, he is a strong contender, although I'm not sure if it's going to be him next. It might well be Sho Sil down here. And again, not too difficult to work out why. God, excuse me. Yeah, piercing attacks, free range, piercing each hit, 80% pierce ratio, and even at gold one, 1493 damage at 80% pierce ratio is really good. Get all three drones out, and he is a menace. So at diamond one, his damage, even with a single drone, is going to be ridiculously good. He can sit back and rain down absolute hell on the enemy. And of course, at high enough level, the drones have a little bit of survivability as well, so they're hopefully going to stick around and inflict a nice amount of damage. He also has camouflage, which makes him a little bit harder to target at range. But yeah, so he's a good one as well. He's got potential. He does well against the Silent King, is one that he does pretty well against Zarek, of course. So yeah, he or Bellator will probably be after Thaddeus Noble. And I could keep going on, but I'm just going to mention one more character. It's not going to be Eldrion. So a lot of people have pushed Eldrion to diamond, but his survivability, his hits himself are less important. I mean, I'll put him up at some point. But I want to speak briefly about the Neurothrope as well. He's at silver 3 at the moment because I haven't had time to elevate him. Lots of resources. Lots of characters, only so many resources. But yeah, he has really nice synergies. Obviously, he synergizes really well with Thaddeus Noble because the Neuroparasite, if the the Neurothrope is a Zoanthrope variant, as any 40k Tyranid nerds will know. So if the Neurothrope lays down hits upon a particular boss, say, of course, Mortarion, or maybe even the tank, although the tank one won't work for this. Thaddeus Noble in support against Mortarion will increase the damage of the Neuroparasite, and you can really stack damage pretty damn effectively on Mortarion. Mortarion is one who tends to chew through my troops very quickly, so I'm keen to develop a strategy against him, of course. So yeah, there's a potential synergy there. I'd like to push this guy to diamond, have a really strong Tyranid, and yeah, that's my strategy there, at least. I'm also thinking about down the line, just briefly. Abraxas is a damn good one as well, of course, with his psychic. He synergizes well with the Neurothrope Thaddeus Noble Dream Team. And, of course, he produces Pink Horrors, who also do pretty good damage, pretty good psychic damage as well. And, yeah, so the stacks will just keep on coming. He is pretty damn good. I think I'm actually more likely to put him to diamond than I am Archimartis. Archimartis is pretty good, but I think Abraxas might be better overall. But yeah, that's it for now. Those are my characters that I've got to diamond, or that I'm going to take up there to basically empower my team and give myself a good chance of doing a decent amount of damage on as many guild raid bosses as I can to help the guild advance. So yeah, that's it. Let me know what you think in the comments. Let me know, of course, who you've got in diamond, why you've got them up there. I know there's a few there. I've seen a few who've even put Tiark up there. I've seen quite a few Space Wolf characters in diamond in the past. But yeah, let me know your choices. Let me know your rationale behind it, if you like. I'm always open to having my mind changed about things. All right. Thank you very, very much for watching, as ever. Until next time.